Yes. My name is Kairi Mänd. I'm planner from Tallinn. But today I will talk about 3D online application, what we made it for Viimsi Municipality and for Haabneeme. I have to say that I will focus on the practical side. I didn't make the application. It's made by Janus Patrick from Hendrikson&Ko. So he could talk more about the technical issues, but I will focus for the need for it, why we need it and how we build it up. But first of all, I will give a short overview about Viimsi Municipality or Haabneeme to explain why we did it. So Viimsi is one of the most fastest growing municipality in Estonia. It's surrounded by the sea and Tallinn, which is the capital. So it's warms actually the one urban area with Tallinn. So it's like a suburb. And Haabneeme is the center of Viimsi. And because of the sea and Tallinn, it's very favorable living area. And but in the other side, there is only one corridor, only one road what connects Tallinn and Viimsi. But every day, a lot of people from Viimsi are going to Tallinn, working there, using services, so there is a huge pressure for the traffic. And it sets limits to the traffic, to the population growth. But in the other hand, why it's very favorable living place, it's there is a huge pressure from developers who want to develop Haabneeme. And in Estonia and also in Haabneeme, the land is owned private, and there are really like big developers. And with the last years, they came suddenly all together and want to plan, start to plan Haabneeme. But and in that time, I was working in Viimsi as a planner. So our issue was actually to bring then all the visions together and realize that actually it's utopical. It's not possible to plan everything to build because it will like double the population. And as I said, there is a really limits for that. So there is also one picture. But Haabneeme, you see, is like a harbor, which is actually today not developed. There is also a lot of vision what to do with that. There is like all the industry areas. And if we will put all the visions together, it's like a little bit like a Silicon Valley. It's a very huge ideas, good ideas, but we have to put them together. And as we know, then in municipality, actually like this decision-making power has political. So in other hand, side, we have developers, and other hand, we have politicians, and we as experts, we have to have a like, dialogue with them and to prove, to show what those visions, how do they fit in this real environment, and that's why we also thought that it's always also a problem that when we have like this 2D planning map, that quite often it's only for experts, planners, and it's not so easily understandable. There is like colors, we will can give a lot of numbers, but can we really get this picture what we will plan there? So we saw that to have really good dialogue with the politicians and developers, we need to have really real picture of everything where we can put existing environment and visions. So that's the way we build up this 3D environment. And we started to do it, there also master plan, and this is like the first part of this master plan, is this application part that I will introduce today. And as I mentioned, this is the main reason was really to have better dialogue with different interested parties. And this application provides overview of the current situation and also all the developer wishes. So we brought together what is the existing land use, building structure, where and what is already planned. So there, it's already finished. It's not in a real environment yet, but we have to realize that this is already planned. So it comes in the future. Then all the different visions that we have still on the table, we haven't started with them, but they are there, so we have to put them already in existing environment. Then we wanted to analyze with application that how many new people will come with that, how it affect the traffic, jobs, and also analyze already a little bit where do we see where different function could be and where could be their centers, connections. And now I will show some picture of the application. I really like that this is, so it's online. It's online use, you have this link, everyone can go there, and this is, it's not used only in bureau, it's really online for everyone. I really like that this, we build it up, this is it's by chapters. You have here, it's the one window, and in you have numbers, chapters, you can put topics, you can put, explain, put more textual part. In other hand, you have legend, layers, and they are connected to each other. We are using orthophoto, basic map. You can move there in environment, having the eye level, and it's all in 3D. And then you can start to switch off, switch on different layers, which here in this example is the white ones are existing buildings, purple ones are the already plans which are already started. And it, when we go now to the next chapter, we always have the, also the previous layers, so we can always switch off new layers. Then we put it in the same application, all the visions. Here you can see the different colors which shows different functions. And right now is the other layers are switched off, but we can switch on then on to see how do they fit together with each other, how do they affect the environment. And we always see it is in 3D, so we all we really have this spatial picture. Then we want to calculate the population density, what is now, what new visions will bring, and it's also after the colors. And then we put the mobility corridors and to, is it as I said, this is the already the work with the master plan, so we can put there the corridors, what we have today, and then we can already start to analyze where do we see we can develop new corridors. And always in a parallel, we can have this textual part and explain as what everything means. We can always take the layers from the other plants and put here, so we will, we have this freedom to put also different plants in the same application. What I like is that it's also a little bit like an analyzing tool. In a planning, it's always, as we know, there is always textual part, there is maps, and they have to be together. They will have synergy with each other. And here we can bring them all together. So we have we don't have limits how much text we want to put here as an input already, how much text we can already get from these maps and analyze and put it here. We can put the pictures, we can make already some conclusions, and so it's a one plan, everything bring it together. And the further options, because it was the first part of the plan process, then SVC, we can, of course, add here more measuring and marking tools, height distance, location markers, more 3D elements, factors, terrain, landscaping, sun angle. Then until here we had like this dialogue with the politicians and developers, but of course it's very needed to have it also with public, and so we, as a further option, we see that we should integrate here also participation tools, also ID gathering, and using there also like this 3D base map always. So even if I, as a like a public user, I can go there, I can leave my idea, but I always have to use this 3D map so that I always have so real picture as possible. And also in a future use that even when we work with the planning proposal, that the saying that we always have like this 3D base map, because we already went to present it to the government, and we already saw this different, that they really understood. They really understood that this year what we got all the visions together, and they understood that actually, yeah, when we see them separately, it's the one thing, but to put the together, we see that we need here actually some compromises. So we already saw that it worked, that this more real environment brought them closer to us. And then, of course, the same, the textual planning principle integrated into the application, that maybe in the future we can always, it's always online, and we can always like use it as a plan, that we have already textual part and maps together. And really hope that this will, then planning becomes more inclusive and realistic, perceptible. Here, I don't know, do I have time more?
Yes, you have 10 minutes.
Oh, then, so yeah, then I can maybe open
please
it.
Please be active and ask questions using Slido application.
Let's see, maybe I can. You can find it also in Viimsi Municipality homepage. So it looks like it's online, and here in left side, you see there are like the chapters. You will take the first one. And you start to move here. It's just. Some layers are not added.
Maybe there are issues with internet connections.
Okay. But yeah, you can move here, you can change the height. And yeah, it needs very good internet connection. You can open here, you have here a legend, then different layers. So you have always from every, all the chapters layer here. You can put your land use, height to see, like here, really like high building are planned. Because it's always also a question where we should plan the high buildings and to really see it in the whole environment. New planned building structure. And yeah, then actually you can use it like it's the like the pilot case, but as a future we see that we could also, you could use it also for like a detail plan or like smaller areas, and so it was first time to do. But it, yeah, this need came from that to really to get like this more real environment. And here in the left side, you can also scroll it and see there is a picture. You can have like this analyze part. Yeah. And If you have a lot of technical questions, then you can contact with Janus Patrick from Hendrikson, and I'm sure that he can really explain more how he built it up in a GIS-based solution. But thank you for your attention.
Okay, do we have questions from the audience? If you don't have questions, so I have one short question. You were talking about public engagement in the planning process. So is it possible to leave a comment in 3D model for the citizen?
Yeah, this is like the further option, yeah, to have like this idea gathering and then yeah, really have like some layers that are really in public use. So they can't like go and change everything, but you make like certain layers for them that they are in public use.
Okay, I saw that you are showing the situation about the traffic. Have you used additional services such as Waze or something else?
It's right now collected everything from like the local municipalities, but of course it's all possible to bring more and more.
Okay, I see. Okay, so thank you very much. Kairi, for your presentation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you.